let him shout and we'll the execution cart. You can ask me anything, but don't expect my answer to be smart. Don't make me use my imagination. I think it must have blown a fuse. Just keep on with your information. Oh yeah, it must be something someone can use. Gadget that you tell me I need. I believe in God or anything guaranteed. I can watch the news at 10 because I know the camera never lies. Just sitting in my armchair, I can see it with my own two eyes. Don't make me use my imagination. I think it must have blown a fuse. Just keep on with your information. Oh yeah, it must be something someone can use. My imagination, I think it must have blown a fuse. Just keep on with your information. Oh yeah, it must be something someone can use. I said don't make me use my imagination. I think it must have blown a fuse. Just keep on with your information. Oh yeah, it must be something someone can use.
Of 17, her drawings in a folio to keep them looking clean. Her tutors all agreed she had a certain je ne sais quoi with her Modigliani body and her face by Renoir.
I like Cézanne, Cézanne, eat something for me. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, it's not what you see. The power of nature is something to feel. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, to me he's serene.
They showed her Botticelli, Rembrandt, Bruegel and Steinbach, and talked of chiaroscuro or the use of Latin dog. But all they really wanted was to get her into bed, and every time they tried it on, this is what she said.
I like Cézanne, Cézanne, he does something for me. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, it's not what you see. The power of nature is something to feel. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, to me it's so real.
Any school of art. She was all alone until the day she lost her heart to a shy and gentle student whose name happened to be Paul. And so they hung their drawings side by side upon the wall.
I like Cézanne, Cézanne, he does something for me. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, it's not what you see. The power of nature is something to feel. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, to me it's so real. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, he does something for me. I like Cézanne, Cézanne, it's you see. The power of nature is something to feel. I like Suzanne, Suzanne. To me, it's so real.
I must go. The song Urban Spaceman, I think it took most of the afternoon, and no, I really, I was in the hotel, we worked solidly, you know, even when we were doing Do Not Adjust Your Set, and we were in Manchester, in a hotel in Oxford Road, and it overlooked a building site, but in those days they didn't call them building sites or brownfield sites, they were called urban spaces. So I thought, and they're sort of putting people on moon and whatnot and Sputniks and whatnot. So I thought, well, urban spaceman. And I thought, I had the idea. And just at that moment, an ambulance went by going, da 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 da. I thought, well, there's a tune.
You went live with them. You were on the live album in City Centre.
Yeah.
And the Hollywood Bowl.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And beyond that, I wondered if you could talk a little bit about your various contributions to Python on the big screen.
Well, I was, the first one was Holy Grail. And I don't know if you noticed, but anytime anything big and heavy is catapulted out of a castle, lands on me. There's a sort of insecurity amongst people who just do words. Gilliam and I, we're both art students, no problem at all. But the others, you know, had a fear of the abstract arts. So their way of, childish way of doing it is to lob something like a giant wooden rabbit onto you. But I shamelessly, as one of the soldiers up beside Cleese in the taunting, you know, he turns around on the reverse angle and says, fetch-y la vache. And I was supposed to just get up and fetch-y la vache. And I thought, I'm being underused here. So when he do the line, I went, quoi? and he went, so surprised, he went, fetch la vache! Which I think actually got a double laugh out of fetch la vache. They came up with the name Raymond Scum. But I've got, no, this is, you know, the thing was that every time, I did four nights at the Hollywood Bowl. Every time I came on with a protest song with the dark glasses and all the bad harmonica and everything else, and I just, all the lights went on in the auditorium. You know, this is huge, you know. I could see it through. I came off, I was like, what's with the lights? Why did all the lights go up? Sorry, won't happen again. Same night, same thing. Third night, fourth night. And again, it was, you know, the Python stick, as it were. Now, when you look at the film, every time there's a cutaway of the audience roaring with laughter, it was filmed during protest song. It's the only time the audience was ever lit. So thanks, chaps. There was a running gag going on Saturday Night Live about the Rutles getting back together again. And I think Lou Bernstein or somebody who promoted them in the first place was offering them $20 million each, an astronomical amount, you know, in the 70s. To get the band back together, because the Beatles had broken up. And so Saturday Night Live were running this gag, and they got George Harrison on the program. And Lorne Michaels stood there with, you know, $3,000 in cash, and was literally waving it under George's nose. He said, see this, George, all this can be yours, just get the guys back together. George goes into his acting mode, what, all of this for me? and Lorne goes, well, no, you have to share it with the others. Maybe you don't have to tell Ringo, you know. These are the jokes, you know. And so the next joke was, you know, Eric hosting the show. And he said, we've got Eric Idle as the host. We've got him because he said he can get the Beatles back together for $300. So deadly dire. And he gets to the show and he said, well, it was a bad phone line and Eric hasn't got the Beatles, he's got the Rutles. Suddenly we're going to need more songs. So I said to him, I knew it, and they were looking at me. Do you reckon you could write 20 more Rutles songs by Thursday lunchtime? You know, it was shown, you know, because it was a big budget, mm-hmm. And it was shown on prime time, which is what it sounds like. It's NBC prime time. best part of the evening. And it got the lowest ratings of any program NBC have ever put out. And the record still stands today. And I'm immensely proud of that, you know. And of course, it came out when Paul had just put out London Town, a new album. And everyone was saying, what do you think of the Rutles? And he's going, yeah. And I met him again not long afterwards. So I said, that wasn't planned, you know. I mean, I'm really sorry if it got in the way of, you know, your publicising London Town. And he said, oh, well, you know, it's affectionate and things like that. But he did not like Eric's performance of Dirk McQuickley. I'm taking great pleasure, because I've never been one for, you know, blowing my trumpet and being, you know, out there doing, you know, eating bugs in Australia or getting a name for myself. But my claim to fame, and I'm proud of this, is that I am one of the very few people on the planet to have been impersonated by Elvis Presley. It is. It is impressive, isn't it? Isn't it?
Absolutely.
Just breathe that in for a moment. Well, I'll tell you how it came about. His favourite film was Monty Python and the Holy Grail. And he knew all the words and could do all the voices. So, I mean, it's a bit of a worry when you think of him doing, you know, Sir Galahad. Is there someone else up there we can talk to? I can't quite see him doing that.
No.
But I can see him doing, bravely bold Sir Robin, run fast from hell. His head smashed in and his heart cut out and his liver removed and his bowels and blood. Did he ever get one of those days? So, well, that's, you know, that was a lot of fun. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Neil. Thank you.
Corn plaster. Lovely to have had you on the show, Milton. Thank you very much. Now, friends, 3 years ago, four unknown boys and one little girl came all the way down from sunny Liverpool. And just look at them now. Six men.
On three, four. Looking for love, life was passing me by. So I sent off me photo, hobbies and age, magazine marriage I tried. The single centuries, lovely Japanese girls have been trained in the art of pleasing men. Be lonely, though no vermin destiny's door. Dollar, they arrange a meeting. My image was wrong, it didn't like me, so I changed my personality. I bought a deluxe Mercy Beat wig, but it was a size too big. What confidence in my new built-up shoes, so smart for winter or summer, undetectable in normal everyday use. Look out, there's a monster coming. Only clothes, I reshape my nose, plastic surgery's best. The popular learn to play the guitar. Learn to play the guitar. In 7 days you could be strumming. Be sociable and kissing technique. Look out, there's a monster coming. Thank you.
Mr. Connolly. Disfiguring ugly my facial hair, I had removed electrically. Rejuvenated my energy cells and regained my virility. I've injured hand on my heart, aim to change any part. I had a machine for a mommy. Be gentle with me, I come to pieces literally. Look out, there's a monster coming. 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 Look out, there's a monster coming.
Deep as the ocean. Rather makes the noises for the talking. There's not a single noise that he can't do. If you've forgotten what a parrot squawk is, oh, all poppycock, Rod can pop a popcorn for you. He'll do the steam escaping, don't mind us leaving duck. He'll fake a razor scraping, or else a cuckoo. I'd rather make the noises for the talking. There's not a single noise that he can't do. This is what I hear when I'm in bed. A bang, a crash, like thunder overhead. Cats meow, a dog's bow wow. The only sleep I get is when I'm dead. The only time he made a bungle was when a tiger in the jungle, with a mighty roar dropped it, with bullets in his head, and rumbled like a cow instead. Moo, my brother makes the noise. Well, you get the idea. There's a lot of sound effects to make, and we had to sort of make them ourselves, invent them on the hoof, as it were. There weren't any sort of CDs in those days, it was the ultimate choices of all these things. So, you know, we're getting wire brushes and going, that sort of thing, and everything. And I felt the call of nature, so I went out the studio and down the corridor, down some steps, and to the restrooms. And when I came back, you had to come back up the steps. And as I came up, you know, I'm facing the front door. My head is almost floor level. And there, silhouetted, you know, in the doorway, were four guys with, you know, tight trousers. Weird hairdos and dark glasses, pointy shoes, and two big miners. Miners? Minders. And I said, oh, it's them. Of course, they recalled here, too, didn't they? Anyway, so back into the studio for a bit. And my curiosity, I wondered what they were doing. So after half an hour, I snuck out again, and I listened outside their studio. And they were working on one of George's songs. I want to tell you, my head is filled with things to say. Slip away. I
honestly, I haven't heard anything like it. You know, but it's that grand piano, somebody pounding it with the F over the E. Best thing I'd ever heard. Anyway, I had to go back into our studio and finish up. My father needs the noise. There was a lot of different kinds of music around. Yeah, okay, thank you.
Stars still burn beneath my keep on moving even when you stand still. Looking for an end and wondering how or when it will. But when it's gone and in the past, the stars will surely last
too. I was sitting in my armchair watching my TV, searching for something half decent to see. I settled on a blockbuster action movie, and in no time at all, the hero was me. I was using strong language, chasing bad guys, all hell breaking loose before my eyes. Explosions, car chases, and fake alibis, but naked babes with tattooed thighs. Ay, 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 eye candy, simulacra chimera. In loco parentis, ay, 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 candy, effluent of plenty boarded on mass media. At the ambassador's reception, I had to get away, so I hid behind a pyramid of Ferrero Rocher. Only to find myself in match of the day, scoring a last-minute goal against the run of play. But no sooner had the referee's whistle been blown, I was sucked into a computer graphic cyclone and dumped on a sofa with a cartoon telephone telling me how easy it can be to get alone. Ay, 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 I can be soap operas as frequentas, wacky co-presenters. Ay, 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 I can be effluent, plenty bodied on mass media. I was being zapped around from place to place, from World War II in color to outer space, trying to save the future of the human race. I was the one with the lumps on his face. I was a TV chef shoving up a courgette. I was an emergency animal hospital vet with my hand up some fluffy family pet. I was trapped inside my own TV set in a mixture of panic and darkest despair. I tapped on the glass to see if someone was there. I saw myself sitting in my own easy chair. I waved, but all I got was an empty stare. I knew I was in trouble, my head was in a spin, my reality dissolving like an aspirin. I was a dog food full of goodness and multivitamins. I was the toilet bowl germ with a wicked grin. Ay, 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 I can be simulacra chimera in loco parentis. Ay, 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 I can be effluent, plenty ported on mass media.
Front loader, team, a midnight candle burned. I believe in believing, I'm deeply concerned. Walking down the runway, through the pouring rain, stretching out my arms like a supersonic plane. God free Daniel, he ain't done nothing wrong. Let him go back to Ohio or wherever he belongs. If all the trees were candles, and who's to say they're not? The world would be a birthday cake, and we could eat the lot. But too many cooks can spoil the broth, and a stitch in time saves nine. A bird in the hand is worth two in the bush, and I'll never change my mind. God free Daniel, he ain't done nothing wrong. Let him go back to Ohio or wherever he belongs. A tightrope walker has a balanced mind, as well as arms and legs. But why do chickens cross the road, not to mention laying eggs? I guess I'll never know or truly understand. Anyhow, it's not just doorknobs that come off in your hand. God free Daniel, he ain't done nothing wrong. Let him go back to Ohio or wherever he belongs. God free Daniel, he ain't done nothing wrong. Let him go back to Ohio or wherever he belongs.
I give myself to you, for I know I've so much to give. Oh, and when I'm feeling this way, there's just one thing I gotta say. Believe me, darling, believe me, I'm incredible. Whenever life becomes inedible, you can rely on me to provide an alternative recipe. Innocent moments of boredom can corrupt you. There are so many bestial things to get up to. The world is a manifestation of you. And me, every star in the sky, every drop in the sea. Open your eyes to the energy of others, the same thing as beauty. All things being equal, it's no surprise that you feel full of emptiness. The path of life is so full of detail. Let me explain the inexplicable.
We want to know.
Let me solve the inextricable.
Take your time.
And then, when I'm through, all the world will see I've given
himself
to me.
Himself to me.
Oh. imitation song. Imitation tune. Imitation words. Empty speech balloons. Never ending news. False economy. Imitation life. For you and me. Poppycock eyed world. Imitation birds, imitation bees, imitation pearls, reality TV, simulated sex.
On the subject of songwriting, I think I'd like to dedicate this next song to all popular songwriters, especially the lyricists, because it's not an easy job. It really isn't. I mean, you've only got to turn the radio on to realize that these things aren't just thrown together, you know. So anyway, I'm not singling anyone out, but this song is dedicated to all popular song lyricists. Candle burned. I believe in believing. I'm deeply concerned. Walking down the runway through the pouring rain, stretching out my arms like a zoo.
supersonic plane. Godfrey Daniel, he ain't done nothing wrong. Let him go back to Ohio or wherever he belongs. If all the trees were candles, and who's to say they're not? The world would be a birthday cake, and we could eat the lot. But too many cooks can spoil the broth, and a stitch in time saves a nine. A bird in the hand is worth two in the bush, and I'll never change my mind. Godfrey Daniel, he ain't done nothing wrong. Chickens cross the road, not to mention laying eggs. I guess I'll never know or truly understand. Anyhow, it's not just door knobs that come off in your hand.
Within a show, and we've decided to call this show Rutalot. And it is entirely based on other people's jokes, and we hope to take it to Las Vegas, don't we?
Yes.
Yeah.
strange man must bear. I'm on my way, I cannot stay another day.
Wonderful to be. You know, not so long ago, and it's been very lucky for me. Thank you. The champagne was Canadian. The hostess sang a song. I contemplated suicide. Then you came along. You're so spontaneous. You hit the spot. Nothing but everything is all you've got. You're so spontaneous. You top the bill. Your elegant savoir faire gives me a thrill. This is the moment is now, the moment is you, come on, take your bow, you're so spontaneous, you knock me flat, you pull those little white rabbits out of my top hat, you're so spontaneous. A brack, a de bras, spontaneous, that's what you are. Take it, fellas. Is now the moment is you, come on, take your bow, you're so spontaneous.
wonder born. Spontaneous, spontaneous, spontaneous. That's what you are.
It's gospel time. We're gonna lay down this song so heavy. It's gonna stay laid. Cause we're gonna witness on this song, brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, we're gonna let it all hang out. And then we're gonna stuff it all back in again. It's gonna be messy, but kind of fun. Cause y'all know what this song is called? This song is called The Slaves of Freedom. What a mother of a concept. All right, let's get down to it. Stamp your feet and clap your hands. We are the slaves of freedom. Some with us a promised land. We are the slaves of freedom. Where we can do what we like. We are the slaves of freedom. When no one gets off their bike, we are the slaves of freedom. And freedom is the handle on the bucket of your soul. The image of illusion in the goldfish of your bowl. The shampoo of perfection in the bathroom of your dreams. Freedom is the universe and everything it sees. Oh yeah. We are the slaves of freedom. We all live until we die. We are the slaves of freedom. There's no sense in wondering why. We are the slaves of freedom. So pick up your heavy load. We are the slaves of freedom. Keep on trucking down that road. We are the slaves of freedom. The management accepts no responsibility for any article of clothing or accessory, such as handbags or umbrellas or books on self-defense or things left unattended of the ladies or the gents. Oh yeah. We are the slaves of freedom. Come on, brothers and sisters, clap your hands. There's two beats to the bar. Pick one of them. All right, that's the easy one. That's all right. All right, we got a groove. Come on. Now let me hear you sing. What are we? We are the slaves of freedom. No. We are the slaves of freedom on that chord. We are the slaves of freedom. All right, one more time. Let's raise a ruckus tonight. We are the slaves of freedom. We are in a funny mood.
We are the slaves of freedom.
Let's do something really rude.
We are the slaves of freedom.
We can't all be wired up.
We are the slaves of freedom.
So let's take out our tongues and... Brothers and sisters, I told you we're gonna let it all hang out. Let it all hang out is what we're gonna do. On a count of three, we are gonna blow raspberries. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. One, two, three. Come on now, children. Some of you, mostly you, thinking too hard. Thinking too hard about people sitting just in front of you.
I'm kind of glad I'm back with this one.
Health and safety.
I know. But you must put them from your mind. And some of you, not you or you, but some of you probably up there are failing. Failing. Failing to appreciate how often it is you get asked to participate in immature themes. So come on, brothers and sisters, this time, the mother load. One, two, three, go for it! All right!
Freedom is the handle on the bucket of your soul. The image of illusion in the goldfish of your bowl. The pedestal of purpose in the bathroom of your dreams. Freedom is the universe and everything it seems. Oh yeah. What are we? We are the slaves of freedom. And clap your hands, come on. We are the slaves of freedom. We say yeah, 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 yeah. We are the slaves of freedom.
Rebound the beat, rebound the bow.
Rebound the beat, rebound the bow.
Rap tap, doodly bop, a shoodly beat, a shoodly wasp. Zoom, 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 boom, zoom. Anyway, just give me an S.
S.
Give me an O.
O.
Give me a D.
D.
Give me another O.
O.
Give me an F.
F.
Another F.
F.
Now what you got?
O.
Right.
Anybody here remember the Rutles?
Yes!
I'm sorry if you're sitting over there. If you can, anyone here can speak Rutlese, and do feel free to sing along with any of it you want to. This is, you know, because I've got this theory about, you know, the Rutles, you know, the word Rutle should really be a verb, should be in the dictionary as a verb, to Rutle. To copy or emulate someone you admire, brackets, especially in the music business. Because when you think about it, the Beatles ruttled Eddie Cochran and Gene Vincent and Elvis, and Mozart ruttled whoever played the harpsichord, he heard it. So anyway, this is the Rutles, and join in. It's a sort of a medley of bits and pieces.
People were proud in Double Back Alley. Neighbors were loud, but ever so pouty. People would shout, joking about the smoke and the soot. Mother would put the milk bottles out. We had a good time in Double Back Alley. Fences to climb in Double Father O'Malley. To clip your ear and steer you clear of the funny. I'm sorry.
sorry, chaps, but the microphone slid down on the street. I don't want to live with that, really, for the whole thing. Actually, let's check this piano's in tune, actually. Yep, it's good enough. If you don't mind, we'll start again, actually.
People were proud in Double Back Alley. Neighbours were loud, but ever so tally. People would shout, joking about the smoke and the soot. Mother would put the milk bottles out. We had a good time in Double Back Alley. Fences to climb and Father O'Malley to clip your ear and steer you clear of the funny man in the ice cream van. Each man must bear. I'm on my way. I cannot stay another day. You're so pusillanimous. Oh, yeah. Nature's calling animus. Go there. In the back of my mind. twice. Ah, at least once more. Man and machine, keep yourself clean, or be a has-been like a dinosaur. Man and device, but everything nice, you better think twice.
Sunset doesn't last all evening. A mind can blow those clouds away. After all this, my love is up, I must believe it. It's not always gonna be this great. Face another day, you know the darkness doesn't stay in the nighttime. In the morning, it'll fade away. And the daylight's good, it'll ride in at the right time. It's not always gonna be this great. All things must pass away. All things must pass. All things must pass away.
Thank you so much for coming tonight.
Now, here's Neil Innes.
Hi there. My name is Solo. Stoop Solo.
See?
I do amazing things. Right now, I'd like to sing for you.
Stormy day.
Stormy day.
Cloudy sky.
Sky.
Wind and rain.
Got
a watery eye.
Watery eye.
yellow leaves fall from a tree.
Well, here's our last studio guest tonight, who needs no introduction from me. So until next week, good night.
Well, this next number is a protest song. I've suffered for my music, and now it's your turn.
Prophets of doom can always find room in a world full of worry and fear. Tip cigarettes and chemistry sets and Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. So I'm going back to my little old shack and drink me a bottle of wine. That was mise en bouteille before my birthday, and have me a fantastic time. Rain on a tin roof sounds like a drum. We're marching for freedom today. Yay! Turn on your headlights and sound your horn if people get in the way. Turn you on to the chromium swan on the nose of a long limousine. Even hide for the day, it is something to say, but what the hell does it mean? I may be accused of being confused, but I'm average weight for my height. My philosophy, like color TV, is all there in black and white. Rain on a tin roof sounds like a drum. We're marching for freedom today. Yay! Turn on your headlights and sound your horn if people get in the way.
Driving all night,
with my headlights on, thinking of you, your feminine form, so soft and warm. I'm a hero on the motorway, flashing my lights, trying to get by. Another hero on the motorway, heading for the fast lane in the sky. Going crazy. I know I'm miles away, but it's such a crazy mixed up world, little darling. At the end of the day, driving all night with my headlights on, thinking of you. Your feminine form, so soft and warm. Ooh, I'm thinking of you. Your feminine form, so soft and warm. I'm a hero on the motorway, flashing my lights, trying to get by. Another hero on the motorway, headed in for the fast lane in the sky.
You Americans are in a bit of a subdued mood because of the important decisions you're having to make at the moment about whether to give the Oscar to little Nicole Kidman or not. Very, very life-enhancing decisions, and she's hopefully going to get the Oscar for Best Actress in Michael Jackson's Old Nose. I don't want to be too too controversial tonight because, you know, I'm from Australia, God's own country, God bless us. And we don't really understand why you're doing all that Iraq stuff, you know. I mean, if Bush wanted to change the government in Baghdad, why didn't he just send you to the Supreme Court? Forget, by the way, that Bush is another word for cunt. Now we've lowered the tone considerably. Let's try the philosopher's song again, shall we? Just one more time, everybody, all right?
This time, put your backs into it and forget there's a moron. I mean a war on.
Immanuel Kant was a real pissant. He was very rarely stable. I digger was a boozy beggar who could dig you under the table.
David Hume,
David Hume,
could out-consume
Schopenhauer and Hegel. And Wittgenstein was a beery swine who was just a schlosser schlegel.
There's nothing Nietzsche couldn't teach about the raising of the wrist. Socrates himself was permanently pissed. John Stuart Mill, of his own free will, on half a punch, and he was particularly ill. Plato, they say, was sticking away, half a grain of whiskey every day. Aristotle was a bugger for the bottle, Hobbes was fond of his dram. And René Descartes was a drunken fart, I drink, therefore I am. Yes, Socrates himself is particularly missed.
Ah, lovely little thing about a bugger when he's pissed.
Stamp your feet and clap your hands.
We are the slaves of freedom.
Somewhere there's a promised land.
We are the slaves of freedom.
Where we can do what we like.
We are the slaves of freedom.
Where no one gets off their bike.
We are the slaves of freedom.
Freedom is the handle on the bucket of your soul. The image of illusion in the goldfish of your bowl. The shampoo of perfection in the bathroom of your dreams. Freedom is the universe and everything it seems. Oh yeah. We'll live until we die.
We are the slaves of freedom.
There's no sense in wondering why.
We are the slaves of freedom.
So pick up your heavy load.
We are the slaves of freedom.
And keep on trucking down the road.
We are the slaves of freedom.
The management accepts no responsibility for any articles of clothing or accessory, such as handbags or umbrellas, or books on self-defense, or things left unattended in the ladies or the gents. Oh yeah. Something really rude.
We are the slaves of freedom.
We can't all be wired up.
We are the slaves of freedom.
So let's stick out our tongues and
spur. We are the slaves of freedom.
Freedom is a handle on the bucket of your soul. The image of illusion in the goldfish of your bowl. The pedestal of purpose in the bathroom of your dreams. Freedom is the universe and everything it seems. Oh yeah.
And this next song is also from that same vintage of Monty Python and the Holy Grail. It's a song called Runaway. It didn't actually see the light of day during the film, and when you hear the song, you realise why. But nevertheless, it is a bit of fun. And so let's celebrate the, sort of the usefulness of fear and running away.
Run away.
This is the way it is going. The chorus sort of goes like, run away, there's no need to stay. Run away, see, when this is where it's nice, if you go, I go, run away, you go, run away. So it goes, run away, run away, run away, run away, run away. It's also Walt Disney, isn't it? So shall we try a chorus? I mean, that's the only bit, you know, it does get a bit sort of jazzy towards the end, but who cares? Run away, run away, run away, there's no need to stay. Run away, run away, run away, discretion is okay. You can always borrow on the strength of tomorrow if you can't win the day. Run away, run away, run away. So you tried it on that one, that'd be good, but who cares, you know. It's nice if there's an echo, you know. So, okay, here we go. Run away, run away. Run away, run away, run away, discretion is okay. You can always borrow on the strength of tomorrow. You come in the day. Run away, run away. That's the jazz I referred to earlier. Every noble knight must fight for what is right. But if the other side don't want to know, history reveals that a clean pair of heels is by far the best thing you can show. Run away, run away, run away, run away. There's no need to stay. Run away, run away, run away, run away. Discretion is okay. You can always borrow on the strength of tomorrow. On the battlefield, and virtue is your shield. The only thing to do is make a stand. But if certain death is near, and you'd rather disappear, you can call upon your feet to lend a hand. Run away, run away, run away, run away. There's no need to stay. Run away, run away, run away, run away. Discretion is okay. You can always borrow on the street. Just turn both cheeks and run. And don't let foolish pride get in the way. In the way. Fantastic. Remember, a retreat is something you can beat. So why not think to fight another day? Run away, run away, run away, run away. There's no need to stay. Run away, run away, run away, run away. It's okay. You can always borrow on the strength of tomorrow if you can't win the day. Run away, run away, there's no need to stay. Run away, expression is okay. You can always borrow on the strength of tomorrow if you can't win the day. Of people in the world. The schizophrenics and the paranoid schizophrenics. Or men and women. I have no fear.
because I'm not going to say anything about women. Apart from the fact that they generalize and men don't. Now, we do seem to be a species where the male and the female are so exquisitely designed as to extract the maximum frustration from one another with the minimum effort. The French have a word for this. It is called la différence. I wonder where they got that. Anyway, to celebrate this difference, I thought I would sing for you a little love song. I am Jean-Paul Sartre, existentialist philosopher and crooner. And I'd like to sing for you a little love song, a petite chanson d'amour, in French. Or at least in a French accent. The song has been specially arranged for me for one guitar and one donkey. This is the guitar. And this is the donkey. Hee-haw, hee-haw. 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 We have no time for lovers' games of hide and seek or cat and mouse. I come on time, you call me names, you work all week at keeping us. I understand the tragedy of what you do, but don't you think the office is the same for me, you ask me to unblock the sink. Life is getting shorter, nickel, dime and quarter. Talk is getting cheaper, love is getting deeper. Hee-haw, 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 hee-haw. I get to work under the sink, I bang my head, the spanner slips. I cut my hand and wish I had a drink, but curse instead the water drips. You nag at me, I raise my voice, the baby's toys are on the floor. You say be quiet, I have no choice, the slightest noise disturbs next door. Life is getting shorter, nickel, dime and quarter. Talk is getting cheaper, love is getting deeper. Hee-haw, 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 Central Pay. The kettle boils, the baby cries, I pick him up, his little teeth are coming through. I dry his eyes, you break a cup, and underneath the kitchen light, your pretty face is close to tears, and so my heart goes out to you. As we embrace, love reappears to play its part. Life is getting shorter. Nickel, dime, and quarter. Talk is getting cheaper. Love is getting deeper. So now, everyone, why not make complete asses of yourselves too? Hee-haw, 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 hee-haw.
The outlook for today is mainly tragic. Cloudy, dull, occasional rain and scattered magic. But unlike those who say they prefer the good old days, I hardly ever feel nostalgic. And although the intellectually agile can logically prove the heart is fragile. Drifting unawares through all of its affairs, nevertheless, love is still the simple badge I'll proudly wear. When does a dream begin? Does it start with a good night kiss? Is it begun when two hearts are one? When does a dream begin? When does a dream begin? Is it born in a moment of bliss? Is it conceived or simply achieved? When does a dream begin? The vision of you appears somehow impossible to resist. But I'm not imagining seeing you now, for who could have dreamed of this? When does a dream begin? When reality is dismissed? Or does it commence when we lose all pretense? When does a dream begin?
There's something to be said for having something to say. Each modest opinion and dogma has its day. Every quip, every quote, every witty anecdote. There's something to be said for having something to say. To pay for saying what you mean is not like meaning what you say. Remember that the more you know, the less you understand. From every word you say is like a footprint in the sand. But there's something to be said for having something to say. Each modest opinion and dogma has its day. Every sentimental verse, every compliment or curse. There's something to be said for having something to say. So come on, everybody, let the working classes and the middle classes and the upper classes and the master classes and any other kind of classes, let all the classes chatter. Let their heads get fatter. Their words won't matter. the tree.
Otherwise known as Nick Cabaret, Nobby Norman, and perhaps the most celebrated survivor of the Bonzo Dog Doo-Dah Band.
Was a ring in your bell.
An eccentric singer and comedian, he's best known for such BBC series as Rutland Weekend Television and, of course, the Innes Book of Records.
Did you stick your head out the window? Find you could not make a sound. Hey, hey, mister, all you need is a little rock and roll, rock and roll. Rock
4 years ago, Innes abandoned life in London to settle here in rural Suffolk. It's in this isolated environment that he comes up with some of his more bizarre creations. Whether doing running repairs to a tailor's dummy that he uses in his stage show, or dreaming up some more parodies lost, he's now back deep among his East Anglian roots.
You'll need about another 50 of the leaflets.
Have you shown them to Judy?
Yes, she likes them.
Good, good. It's hopefully yet as a designer.
Mm.
I'll run them through.
Since moving to the village of Debenham, he and his wife Yvonne have become closely involved with the peace movement. These fundraising cards are based on a huge banner. The idea came from Yvonne and a friend, and about 40 peace groups contributed towards the design. Born in Essex, Innes went to school and later to art college in Norwich before winning a place at Goldsmiths in London. His home now is a 16th century farmhouse half a mile down a narrow lane. The lane was built along the course of a stream, and in winter it's often under 6 inches of water. Expeditions to clear away fallen branches have become a regular part of life for the Inneses and their children. While Yvonne teaches drama in the village, Neil uses his self-imposed isolation to focus on what now really matters most to him, the writing of songs and sketches that have established him as a pioneering and often revolutionary Baroque comedian.
Come on, help me, help me, help me, help me, help me, help
A comedian sometimes prepared to work with other groups, notably the Monty Python team, but essentially this very private family man is a loner who has managed to blend poetry and music and humour into a unique and very curious mix. He may never have wanted to become the seventh Python, but he's certainly the first and only Innes.
Should we bring him here?
That's it, because I don't like him.
Should we bring Tom here?
All the little pigs, they grunt and howl.
Grunt, howl, grunt, howl.
The cats meow.
Meow, meow.
The dogs bow, bow.
Ruff, 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 ruff.
Everybody makes a row down on Jollity Farm. All the little birds go tweet, tweet, tweet. The lambs all bleat and shake their feet. Everything's a perfect treat down on Jollity Farm. Regular as habit, the cocks begin to crow. And the old buck rabbit sings,
stuff it up a jumper.
Vododio. All the little ducks go quack, quack, quack. The cows all moo. The bull does too. Everyone says, how do you do down on Jollity Farm?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's wonderful to be. You know, not so long ago, and it's been very lucky for me. Thank you.
I'm the urban spaceman, baby. I got speed. I got everything I need. I'm the urban spaceman, baby. I'm intelligent and clean. I was going to do the short version. You know mine. Middle version. I wake up every morning with a smile upon my face. My natural exuberance spills out all over the place. I'm the urban spaceman, baby. Here comes the twist. I don't exist.
Thank you. Thank you very much, that was. That was, of course, a medley of hit. And now, pathos. Has anyone here ever been stuck to the outside of a moving bus? I have. One night, I got so stoned, I ate all my fridge magnets. The next day, so I wrote a little song about the experience, and it's kind of a short blues.
Shout, don't you know about the smoke of the soot?
Come play some early, Rutles.
To hold and be. got speed. I've got everything I need. I'm the urban spaceman, baby. I can fly. I'm a supersonic guy. I don't need pleasure. I don't feel pain. If you were to knock me down, I'd simply get up again. Cause I'm the urban spaceman, baby. I'm making out. I'm all about. My face, my natural exuberance spills out all over the place. Well, I'm the urban spaceman, I'm intelligent and clean. I'm sure you all know what I mean. Yes, I'm the urban spaceman, and a lover second to none. Let my friends down, I've never made a fool. I'm a glossy magazine, an advert on the tube. I'm the urban spaceman, baby. Here comes the twist.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's wonderful to be. You know, it's been my brother, and it's been very lucky for me. Thank you.
The champagne was Canadian. The hostess sang a song. I contemplated suicide. Then you came along. You're so spontaneous. You hit the spot. Nothing but everything is all you've got. You're so spontaneous. You top the bill. Your arrogance of a fair gives me a thrill. For this is the moment is now, the moment is you. Come on, take your bow, you're so spontaneous. You knock me flat, you pull those little white rabbits out of my top hat. You're so spontaneous, a brack of a broad. Spontaneous, that's what you are.
Take it first.
Spontaneous.
There's a, it looks like there's a Frenchman on the side of the stage who looks like he's coming up to entertain us.
Take the top off.
The Bonzo Dog Doo-Dah Band.
Yeah.
A ukulele has arrived. Monty Python, The Life of Brian.
Yeah.
Python songs. And a little movie that came together on Saturday Night Live. There's a British expression, this seems like a bad word to say in America, but it's not in England. They call it taking the piss. It was a group of people, of Eric Idle from Monty Python, and this next gentleman, and a few others, and just taking the piss on the entire Beatles mythology. And it went over so well, and they had so much fun, they said, why don't we just make an entire movie about this fictitious band called the Rutles. And the point is that the music is absolutely fantastic. Please welcome to the stage our next guest, Mr. Neil Innes.
Telling myself I'm all right.
How's it go? How's it work?
Well, yeah. I'm mind game. No, we it's always great being here, but it is you know.
It is very much a full-on weekend, but it's one of the best weekends in the world, anywhere. Yeah. It's just wonderful to see generations again, kids playing guitars out there and everyone singing and doing. I don't think we appreciate just how much the Beatles meant to us all, you know? We're closer to the Beatles than we think. It's part of our DNA, you know, that kind of glue. It reminds us that we are social creatures. You know, we belong around the campfire singing things.
Exactly. And socially, there's an interesting story. There's a documentary on Netflix called The Impact of the Beatles. It's how the Beatles changed the world. And a writer, a friend, Anthony McCurtis from Rolling Stone, made a point, I mentioned it earlier today, and I never thought of it. I mean, I guess I knew it, but didn't really get a sense of it. You know, Elvis had a pompadour, these peg leg pants had a look. Every generation of teenagers who had a look, and the adults would laugh and go, look at that crazy clothes. The Beatles come along, and as we get to the late 60s, the world follows them. You've got 45-year-old stockbrokers now with long hair, wearing paisley ties, and purple jackets, and Beatle boots. It never happened before that the adult culture went, you gotta follow the kids. When did that ever happen, ever since?
Well, one can only hope it will happen again.
Yes.
Because the kids are making good noises.
Amen to that.
Kindly noises. But, you know, I think as long as it's within living memory, you know, that we are at our best sometimes when things get bad. You know, I think, excuse me being scholarly, but Plato, hymn of Socrates' buddyhood, said that the only way that tyranny can take place is when democracies become complacent. And I think, you know, we all agree that let things slip a bit. You know, not just that, certainly in Britain we have. It's out of control. We've got strangeness going on from government, and I don't think you're too distant from that situation here either. You know, but I'm not going to get down on one side or the other, but
At the end of the day, something's got to be true.
Well, for me, the Beatles always challenged the status quo.
Yeah.
You know, that's the biggest thing they did, was shake up the world. They made it color from black and white. And, you know, there's never more color. Just look at the lights going on the ceiling right now. Those were appropriate lights for the fest for Beatles fans. Give me another scenario where that should be going in the ceiling when we're talking about music. That's, they brought color back to the world. And it's one of my favorite stories that Neil Innes has ever told, is that they're in Abbey Road and they're recording, and Paul McCartney walks in the studio and says, "Hey, son, what are you working on? Do you remember this? Do you remember the song you were working on?"
"Well, yeah, it was a thing called My Brother Makes the Noises for the Talkies." "No, but it was slightly like that. But I went to listen to them."
"Oh, okay."
"And they were doing George's I Want to Tell You. And all that kind of thing. And I hadn't heard anything like it, you know. Because we were having great fun finding these old records from the 20s and the 30s, where, you know, the terrible depression and everything else, there was a great sense of humor. Songs like The Stalkers Brought a Son and Daughter to Mr. and Mrs. Mickey Mouse. You know, and Jollity Farm, and Hunting Tigers Out in India, and things like that, and Ali Baba's Camel. And we just found these things, and we were making a thing called My Brother Makes the Noises for the Talkies. And the story goes, you know, that I went to listen to this thing, and I said, why am I going back into the studio and going, My Brother Makes the Noises for the Talkies? You know, in the same week that they were doing that. So, I mean, they were well ahead of the game. No one had ever achieved the popularity, never mind what populist politicians try to do or the media that feeds them. They genuinely, you know, caught people's imaginations and their emotions. And as Derek Taylor, the press agent, said, you know, a lot of people said, "Oh, well, the Beatles caught the bus." He said, "No, the Beatles were the bus."
Well said. There's a great moment that I've learned in this past year. I've been doing these podcasts, like Ken Dasho's Beatles Revolution. You guys are so kind to actually listen to this crazy stuff. But rather than me just blabbering, I love having guests. When Neil comes up to the station next week, we're going to do one and all this, and getting information about the routine of music. And Steve Hackett was in town, the guitarist from Genesis. Brilliant, good guitarist, lovely guy. And
you come up with some musical ideas and how to film them. Remember, it's got to be cheap. And so I thought one of them would be, well, let's do A Hard Day's Night. It's black and white, it's speeded up like Benny Hill. Four guys in tight trousers with pointy shoes and wigs running around the field. Sorted. I came up with this kind of list song, like good, bad, happy, sad, blah, blah, blah. And the middle eight was interesting. But I thought the whole thing was just as a platform, if you like, to do the parody of A Hard Day's Night. So when we met up, I said, "I got this." He said, "That's great, because I got this idea for a documentary maker who's so boring, the camera runs away from him." So these two things were put together in the Rutles Weekend Show. You see, spool on the Saturday Night Live, and they're already running the gag, you know, because Sid Bernstein's trying to get the Beatles back together again, offering $20 million each, or a killer whale as a pet. And getting George on there and waving $3,000 in cash, because that's the union rate for four musicians on Saturday Night Live in those days. And George was saying, "Oh, all of this for me." He said, "No, you have to change it. Have to share it with the others. You know, maybe you don't have to tell Ringo." But these jokes were out there, you know. And so when they said, we got Eric to host the show on the premise that he said he could get the Beatles together for $300, you know, he started to get the joke and things like that. And then at the end, the last minute, he said, Rawlins to come on and said, "Well, in fact, it was a bad phone line. You know, Eric hasn't got the Beatles back together, but he's got the Rutles." So they showed the clip from the BBC programme, Rutles Weekend Television, of the song and the camera running away. And then, bless, everybody wrote in and wanted to play in the same sandpit, the same toys. And they said, "No, well, let's have the Rutles, you know." And so Lorne said, "Well, we have to do the whole show. We have to do the whole story." And so he got the budget, you know, went downstairs for about 7 minutes and came back and away we were. And I remember
Well, because I was sitting away from them all, getting all excited, and I was sitting on a windowsill because I knew at some point they were going to say, oh, we're going to need some more songs.
right.
So it came, can you write 20 more Rutles songs for me next Thursday lunchtime? So I said, I'll try. You know, and I got a following wind, and we did it. And I've never been involved in a project where everybody kind of knew what to do or had so much fun. And if ever there's a kind of pay the bank of fun, you know, we all got showered notes of pay the bank of fun, because everybody had fun on that project.
And for anybody who said, well, why are they just like the Beatles? They don't like the Beatles. Did you not see George Harrison in the movie?
George was in it up to his neck. He really wanted to do this, you know. He was saying, no, it wasn't like that. It was like this, you know.
And they were doing this
yes,
way.
Yes.
They see the people running out of Apple. What about theft? And they're running with typewriters.
Yeah. Well, we've got to put a stop to this bit of petty pilfering. And George was playing the television interview, and Michael Palin was playing Derek Taylor, the press agent, you know, trying to
explain it. Yeah. Trying to explain it away. You want to play a little music? Perchance to dream to play?
Well, we were sort of talking earlier about the sort of complexity of politics.
Yes.
And things like that. I have this song I wrote under conditions of extreme luxury in the Bahamas or Barbados, wherever it was.
So we have it's ukulele. It's ukulele. It's coming.
And anyway, it's kind of got a reggae feel, but I call it an old English Brexit lament. Let's face it, like it or not, each and every as each other in a democracy, even those who are helpless, through no fault of their own, no serene. Just remember, they are our children, and they rely on us. Like it or not, each and every one of us should be as important as each other in a democracy. Even those who are no good at anything, no serene. We all have our process to bear. Join with me in a democracy. Oh yeah. We all have our process to bear.
Good to this year. Love you. One of the funniest lines anybody has ever said on a stage. Secret policeman's ball. and Neil walks out in the Elton John Tommy boots, the hair and the hat, and as Neil Young, with a harmonica in a brace, simply says, "I suffered for my music. Now it's your turn." we have more to go. We have more time. No, that's as funny a line as anyone's ever said.
I got it on a t-shirt if you want. It's only $19.99.
Yes, I'm buying one. Brilliant. That, along with the Rutles.
George pinched down for his book.
Did he really?
Yeah, he did. But he didn't acknowledge, you know. It's thanks. Neil Innes and Eric Idle for their terrible jokes.
That's not really an acknowledgement, George.
Yeah, sort of. That's the most backhanded compliment anyone could ever give you. How did you and George connect on a friendship level? How did that come about?
I don't know. When we did the Magic Mystery Tour,
Bonzo's were the band. If you ever saw the Magical Mystery Tour, they're the band that's playing the club.
Yeah, it's just club. And we never really got past that.
A highlight.
It was. No, he came up and said, "I really like that song." It was called Death Cab for Cutie, for some reason.
Took it out. That's the name of the band.
And I got the title when I was looking for these old 78s in the junk shops and the street markets. I found some magazines, and true crime magazine. And this one I looked at, the two lurid kind of things on the front said, "Death Cab for Cutie." And the other one said, "It was a great party until somebody found a hammer."
That's another great song title.
I know, we did it. But the Beatles weren't interested. No, we did it in a kind of very Dada way. The band was like that. We got all these secondhand squashed brass instruments and stuff like that for nothing. And we handed out damaged trombones, euphoniums to a whole audience of people. And there was a kind of Dada. Fearful rap. And Vivian was going, "It was a great party, and just somebody found a hammer, yeah." It was crap. But it was exuberant crap.
Which is the most important.
Yeah.
Steve Winwood came up to the station this year. He's touring, and I said to him, "You know, lyrics. I love Traffic, just the greatest thing, for all of it, Spencer Davis, Traffic, Blind Faith, all of it." And I said, I never want to put people on the spot, but "Hippos Don't Wear Hats, Lobster Shriek Would Provoke." And he went, "Oh, Viv Stanchall wrote that." But I should have known. Who else would write something that insane?
Actually, I forgot about it. We did a 3-hour Radio 4 tribute to Viv. English was tuppence. And it popped into my head, I'd forgotten about it, and my quote is that he tossed the English language, called heads, and won. No, he was just extraordinary. He loved words, you know, I mean, he couldn't leave them alone. And in fact, sometimes with lyrics, he was like, "That'll do it, you know, you're not going to get it any better." You know?
Right.
But right in the early days, when we'd be playing some songs like last night, he changed the lyrics on us. You know, we'd be playing it, and he'd get up to do the vocal, and instead of singing "Last Night on the Back Porch," he goes, "If skirts get any shorter, said the flapper with a song, I'll have two more cheeks to powder and a lot more hair to pop."
And that's how you he's going to do
it. Yeah, I know, but of course we can't play for long.
Does anybody here know my favorite Bonzo song, which is a little thing called the intro and the outro? Oh, yeah. That is the Sergeant Pepper of the Bonzo world, if you will.
It was done on 4-track, 1-inch.
So you had to keep bouncing every show?
Bounce.
Yeah. It's the entire thing is simply introducing the band.
Huge band.
It's a very big band. Adolf Hitler on Vaughn.
Looking very relaxed.
Nice.
Yes, nice one.
That's how far out the Bonzo Dog Doo-Dah Band. The name was just, what's the silliest name?
It came out of a hat. Bonzo Dog was a cartoon character on postcards, naughty seaside postcards. A beautifully drawn, George Study was the artist. And Dada, the turn of the century anti-art movement. It was started in 1916 because of the First World War. You know, they said, this can't go on, you know, and then they did a really strong anti-art movement. But not many people have heard of it. And Bat was in there as well. So the three that came out was Bonzo Dog, Dada, Band. And that was what it was. When we all rehearsed every Tuesday night at the Royal College of Art canteen, we were the Bonzo Dog Dada Band. But, you know, after a while, I said, got tired of trying to explain what a turn of the century anti-art movement was, so we changed it to Doo-Dah.
As a campaign racist.
Yeah,
Doo-Dah.
And then we, for one reason or another, we stopped doing old things, largely because the new vaudeville band ripped us off completely.
Right.
When we turned down the offer to be the new vaudeville.
Really?
Yeah.
You could have been with Chester Cathedral.
I trumpeted Bob Kerr, you know, said, who knew Jeff Stevens, who'd written it, who's got a hit with it, but no band in session. And he said, Bob, you'll go out on the road with this crazy band. You know, do you want to be the new vaudeville band? So he came rushing in and said, we can be the new vaudeville band. We can be on top of the pops. And the rest of us went, why? Why? And he said, well, I'm going to do it. We said, off you go then. Never darken our towels again. But the thing was that when they appeared on television, they looked exactly like us, a singer in an army suit. Musicians in sort of pinstripe gangster suits with terrible ties. Here's a competition for finding the best tie. Anyway, two-toned shoes and a cardboard cutout, you know, for hard speaking, but saying, wow, I'm really expressing myself. And that was all on television. So wherever we went, people said, oh, you like that vaudeville band.
That's
fine. Yeah, and we said, they went, ugh. And then Larry, next Larry Smith, our drummer and tap dancer, said, why don't we do any kind of music? We thought, that's the only way. We'll dress it, wear what we like, do what we like, any kind of music. And that really, we wouldn't have started writing songs. So it's like, one thing turns into another.
Right, we don't get the Urban Space Band if you ain't gone on.
No.
So, right, we never would have got one of my favorite songs.
Yeah!
Speaking of songs, as the clock is winding down, can we get another song for you, Ms. Grandis? We have 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Can I bring Ken on?
Yes, Ken. Ken, come, Ken. Ken, sit here. Ken, sit here. Let's slide over here.
Oh.
Do you have a pick? You need a pick.
Songs are what they are, and they should be about what we are. And this is a song I wrote before. Well, let's put it this way: it's about absent friends. It's about absent friends. This song, and. Some of us had yesterday that very lovely lady called Nicole with the yellow submorons. And she was a vivacious and lovely, but she's decided to go somewhere else. And so I would like to dedicate this song to her. Okay. I haven't played as much, but I think we should do it.
Please.
For everyone who, you know, who can't be here tonight.
Okay.
Whoa, yeah, can we have a little balance, maybe? Can you hear me?
Yeah. Can we hear me?
Can I hear me?
No.
A little monitor. Okay. Lovely. Okay.
One, two, three.
Just a matter of time is the clinical view. Nobody wants to die, but it can hit you right between the eyes when you're talking about friends at the end of the line. You put the phone down, think you don't got another, and close your tears. You selfishly begin to count up all the love that you've lost over the years. Try to picture their faces while there's something going on in the place where your stomach used to be. And then you realize it's the oldest and the coldest fear ever known to humanity. Fallen fruit must decompose. Feed the bugs and busy those who squirm around in the graveyard bug. Empty bed pans and wash away the blood. Oh my, nobody wants to die, but it could you right between the eyes when you're talking about friends at the end of the line.
Come on, gentlemen, right there.
which of course is perhaps something reptilian? Something reptilian?
Yeah.
I just made up that word. Or perhaps
do you want
Brave Sir Robin. I suggested Brave Sir Robin. Neil, it's perfection. It's perfection. And I'm laughing, and the man hasn't even put the guitar on his neck yet. Smoke in the water. Good suggestion.
Actually, I know its name, but it's just a bit tacky, a bit brightly. Very difficult, you know, tuning guitar and telling jokes, but it happened to me once at BB King's. And I put this old Abbott and Stella joke in my head. Once upon a time, there were two Irishmen. Now, wrong way.
I'm professional. Trust
you can
me.
Do it.
Now look how many there are. Then stay with it, don't you? Okay, my popular demand then.
Ken's demand and yours, yes.
Yeah.
How dare you, sir?
Just look knowledgeable. Hang on, got tights?
I can take my pants off, but we don't want to go that way.
On second thoughts, we don't have
no.
Bravely Bonzo Robin rode forth from Camelot. He was not afraid to die, oh, brave Sir Robin.
Everybody.
He was not at all afraid to be killed in nasty ways. Brave, 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 brave Sir Robin. He was not in the least bit scared to be mashed into a pulp, or to have his eyes gouged out and his elbows broken, to have his kneecaps scratched and his body burnt away, and his limbs all hacked and mangled, brave Sir Robin. His head smashed and his heart cut out, and his liver removed, and his bowels are cut, and his nostril ripped, and his bottom burnt up, and his penis split with the tip. But you get the idea.
That's fantastic.
I have to tell you that, you know, I think a year or so ago, a friend told me that he'd got friends researching a book on Elvis Presley. And it turns out that Monty Python and the Holy Grail was his favorite of all time films. Yeah, and he knew every word, and he could do all the voices.
Really?
Yeah. So that makes me one of the few people on the planet to have been impersonated by Elvis Presley.
Mr. Neil Innes. Have you ever had one of those days? Neil Innes, Kent, thank you so much. Love you, sir. Will you be around this weekend? Are you going to be outside? Will you be outside? He'll be outside to sign whatever. And, you know, for those of you, we have many new people. It's their first year at the fest. Do we have all our newbies with us? How many people first year, first time? This is just wonderful. This is how it goes. It don't really end. It just keeps going. There's more music. There's a jam session. Mark Rivera's coming out later. Please stick around. We have more for you. Once again, Neil Innes.
And if you know the backing vocals, join in.
Because actually, if you saw the movie, did you see the movie this morning?
Yeah!
In the, thank you, in the lava lounge, you know, everyone's just trying to take it back and make it really through me. Anyway, ouch. Two, a one, two, three. Ouch!
Song Urban Spaceman. I think it took most of the afternoon. And no, I really, I was in the hotel. We worked solidly, you know, even when we were doing Do Not Adjust Your Set. And we were in Manchester, in a hotel in Oxford Road, and it overlooked a building site. But in those days, they didn't call them building sites or brownfield sites. They were called urban spaces. So I thought, and they're sort of putting people on moon and whatnot, and Sputniks and whatnot. So I thought, well, urban spaceman. And I thought, I had the idea. And just at that moment, an ambulance went by going, da na 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 na. I thought, well, there's a tune.
You went live with them. You were on the live album in the City Centre.
Yeah.
And the Hollywood Bowl.
Yes.
And beyond that, I wondered if you could talk a little bit about your various contributions to Python on the big screen.
Well, I was, the first one was Holy Grail, and I don't know if you noticed, but anytime anything big and heavy is catapulted out of a castle, lands on me. There's a sort of insecurity amongst people who just do words. Gilliam and I, we're both art students, no problem at all. But the others, you know, had a fear of the abstract arts. So their way of, childish way of doing it is to lob something like a giant wooden rabbit onto you. Yes. But I shamelessly, as one of the soldiers up beside Cleese in the taunting, you know, he turns around on the reverse angle and says, fetch-y la vache. And I was supposed to just get up and fetch-y la vache. And I thought, I'm being underused here. So when he to the line, I went, qua? And he went, so surprised, he went, fetch it in the vache! Which I think actually got a double laugh out of fetch it in the vache. They came up with the name Raymond Scum. But I've got, no, there's a, you know, the thing was that every time, I did four nights at the Hollywood Bowl. Every time I came on with a protest song with the dark glasses and all the bad harmonica and everything else, and I just, all the lights went on in the auditorium. You know, this is huge, you know. I could see it through. I came off, I was like, what's with the lights? Why did all the lights go up? Sorry, won't happen again. Same night, same thing. third night, fourth night. And again, it was, you know, the Python stick, as it were. Now, when you look at the film, every time there's a cutaway of the audience roaring with laughter, it was filmed during protest song. It's the only time the audience was ever lit. So thanks, chaps. There was a running gag going on Saturday Night Live about the Beatles getting back together again. And I think Lou Bernstein or somebody who promoted them in the first place was offering them $20 million each, an astronomical amount, you know, in the 70s, to get the band back together because the Beatles had broken up. And so Saturday Night Live were running this gag, and they got George Harrison on the program. And Lorne Michaels stood there with, you know, $3,000 in cash and was literally waving it under George's nose. And said, "See this, George? All this can be yours. Just get the guys back together." George goes into his acting mode, "What? All of this for me?" And Lorne goes, "Well, no, you have to share it with the others. Maybe you don't have to tell Ringo, you know." These are the jokes, you know. And so the next joke was, you know, Eric hosting the show. And he said, "We got Eric Idle as the host. We've got him because he said he can get the Beatles back together for $300. So, deadly dire. And he gets to the show and he said, "Well, it was a bad phone line and Eric hasn't got the Beatles, he's got the Rutles. Suddenly, we're going to need more songs." Yeah. So, I knew it. And they were looking at me. "Do you reckon you can write 20 more Rutles songs by Thursday lunchtime?" You know, it was shown. Because it was a big budget, mm-hmm. And it was shown on prime time, which is what it sounds like. It's NBC prime time, best part of the evening. And it got the lowest ratings of any program NBC have ever put out. And the record still stands today. And I'm immensely proud of that. You know. And of course, it came out when Paul had just put out London Town, a new album. And everyone was saying, "What do you think of the Rutles?" And he's going, "Yeah." And I met him again not long afterwards. I said, that wasn't planned, you know. I mean, I'm really sorry if it got in the way of, you know, your publicising London Town. And he said, "Oh, well, you know, it's affectionate and things like that." But he did not like Eric's performance of Dirk McQuickley. I'm taking great pleasure, because I've never been one for, you know, blowing my trumpet and being, you know, out there doing, you know, eating bugs in Australia or getting a name for myself. But my claim to fame, and I'm proud of this, is that I am one of the very few people on the planet to have been impersonated by Elvis Presley. It is. It is impressive, isn't it? Isn't it?
Absolutely.
Just breathe that in for a moment. Well, I'll tell you how it came about. His favourite film was Monty Python and the Holy Grail. And he knew all the words and could do all the voices. So, I mean, it's a bit of a worry when you think of him doing, you know, Sir Galahad. "Is there someone else up there we can talk to?" I can't quite see him doing that.
No.
But I can see him doing, "Bravely bold Sir Robin, blood flows from him. His head smashed in and his heart cut out and his liver removed and his bowels and blood. Did you ever get one of those days?" So, well, that's, you know, that was a lot of fun. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Neil. Thank you.
Thing called blue, my new next name. ground. You right from the start. Now when we meet all kinds of things, it seems upset the apple cart.
Ouch,
don't deserve me, ouch, please don't hurt me, ouch. The fake Rutles are something else, aren't they? But no one is a fake Rutle. There's no such thing as a fake Rutle, because Rutle is not a noun. Rutle is a verb. To Rutle means to copy or emulate someone you admire. Brackets, especially in the music business. Close brackets. So, this makes just about everybody in the world a Rutle. We Rutle our parents, we Rutle, well, we're a bunch of copycats, really, aren't we? Okay, so, but it's time to stop playing the game. When we first did the Rutles, we pretended the Beatles didn't exist. And we kept it going for as long as possible, I think, but people have realized there's a kind of connection now. Sometimes it takes that long. But anyway, here's a song. When I first saw these guys do it, I thought, this is amazing. So come on, boys, take it away. We'll be right back.
to travel in bath cubes until the slump came. Ooh. And faced with redundancy, he turned his mind to other things, and that is how he made his name. He's the Knicker Elastic King. Knicker Elastic King. Self-made man with a business to run, something to sell to everyone. Knicker Elastic King. Ooh la la. Knicker Elastic, everybody used it. Knicker Elastic, nobody refused it. Knicker Elastic King. The Knicker Elastic King. He grew so rich the gnomes of Zurich were green with envy. The darling of the stock exchange made the New Year's honors list and won the Queen's award to industry. Knicker Elastic, essence of propriety. Knicker Elastic, upholder of society. Knicker Elastic King. Business kept expanding, but then disaster. Ooh-hoo. The price of raw materials, coupled with inflation, brought about his downfall. The bottom fell right out of the market. And that's the story of the Knicker Elastic King. The Knicker Elastic King. A self-made man with a business to run, with something to sell to everyone. Knicker Elastic King. Ooh la la. The Knicker Elastic King.
I give myself to you, for I know I've so much to give.
Oh,
yeah. When I'm feeling this way, there's just one thing I gotta say. Believe me, darling, believe me, I'm incredible. Whenever life becomes inedible. You know,
no,
you can't rely
on
me to provide an alternative recipe. Innocent moments of boredom can corrupt you. There are so many bestial things to get up to. The world is a manifestation of you and me. Every star in the sky, every drop in the sea. Open your eyes to the energy of others. The same thing as beauty, all things being equal. It's no surprise that you feel full of emptiness. The pattern of life is so full of detail. Let me explain the inexplicable.
We want to learn.
Let me solve the inextricable.
Take your time.
And then, when I'm through, all the world will see I've given myself to me.
Whoa.
Richard and Cambridge Cox. He was the one with a friend, third from the end, who never took off his socks.
Hi there. Here we are at the discotheque. Everybody's looking great and smelling pretty good too. Okay. Here's a brand new dance. I'll tell you how it's done. It's a little unusual and not much fun. It's not like the bump. It's not like the hustle. And it'll never, never, never be filmed by Ken Russell. It's a hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get, hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. It's easy to do, you soon get the knack. You just shrug your shoulders and turn your back. And do the hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get, hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. It's easy to do, you soon get the knack. You just shrug your shoulders and turn your back. Do the hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. Hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. Where are you?
Here I am.
Come and get me.
Okay, ready or no, here I come.
Hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. Hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. Hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get. Hard to get, hard to get. Everybody's doing the hard to get.
Well, everybody is doing.
Thank you very much. Most sincerely.
When does a dream begin? Does it start with a good night kiss? Is it conceived or simply achieved? When does a dream begin? When does a dream begin? Is it born in a moment of bliss? Or is it begun when two hearts are one? When does a dream exist? The vision of you appears somehow impossible to resist. But I'm not imagining scenes. For who could have dreamed of this? When does a dream begin? When reality is dismissed? Or does it commence when we lose all pretense? When does a dream begin?
lezione, una paloma, macaroni. Forget about your point of view, the choice is up to me, not you. Factory floor, hotel bar, department store, elevator, lavatory. There is no escaping me. I got nothing to sing about, nothing at all. Tra la 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 la, wall to wall. Shooby dooby, come what may, I play for you. Night and day. Moderato con espressione, una paloma, macaroni. Forget about your